Hey yo, what's up guys? It's your boy, Westside Reptiles, aka Chris, and we in a different location. Peep this. We out here in the living room, bro, because my grandma ain't here working, so I could finesse the living room real quick. So that's what we're gonna do. We got that natural sunlight, so hopefully the lighting should be kind of fire, bro. And we're just gonna be feeding my invertebrates. This is feeding my invertebrates. Let's get into it. It's only three, so... Yeah, I don't know why it's like my invertebrates because I have more, but it's only three. So yeah, real quick though, y'all gotta peep the drip. Damn, peep the drip, peep the drip. Got the Johnny Test socks with the shirt that's three times too small.
I threw up.
What the fuck? What the fuck was that?
What can I say, bro? Drip too hard. I drip too hard, bro. Okay, but nah, guys. In all seriousness, we got some roaches. We got a praying mantis. My centipede that will hopefully eat, even though it just molted. But it's been about a week. Wait, this is my centipede. I'm kind of dumb. So yeah, the centipede and then some isopods I want to check up on. And I'm also going to show you guys what I feed them. So yeah. Let's open this thing up real quick. Okay, so we got the mantis. My little female hopefully is pregnant. And we're gonna see if she takes some food. Since she is a little preggers, she has been hungry lately. So got this little red runner. You interested? Oh, you see how the roach has water in it? That's actually because I'm squishing the roach and it must have just drank water right before I'm about to feed it to this praying mantis, so it's kind of crazy. The praying mantis is looking pretty scared. Now she's kind of looking interested. Come on. What are you doing? I know. Yeah, she's looking pretty scared, bruh. Oh, yeah! That's what I'm talking about. She is just gonna munch on that thing like there's no tomorrow. See if I could get a better shot. So yeah, guys, her mandibles are something else. I can't even explain how they work because I don't even really understand how they work. Okay, we gonna put the flash on. But yeah, she is just chewing down on that arm, bruh. Look at that. Look how much she's already eaten of the roach. It's probably been like 30 seconds. She's just chewed the freaking face off like a goddamn zombie. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. She does not play games. Dude, her babies are gonna be looking so dope. Look how pink she is. Oh, god damn, that junk gooey gooey. Look like the jelly candy you be getting for Halloween. Yo, if my dog don't shut the hell up with your truffling air. Look at that. Look at that freaking mandible. Look at how crazy advanced that thing looks. Jeez, man. Just pierces through that freaking exoskeleton like nothing. That's the roach's head, by the way, that it's munching on right now. It's literally just chewing its face off. It went neck first, bit a huge U-shaped hole in the neck, and then is now chewing the face off. Like, goddamn, bruh. Something kind of interesting about praying mantis. Oh, she got scared of me. Don't look at me like that. But the females, which is this one, they have much shorter antennas, which is kind of weird. I have no idea why, but yeah, that's one way to tell between male and female. And also, females have that much rounder body. The males will have like a nice and slim abdomen, which is just that fat thing that's pulsating right now. Praying mantis has. Yeah, that fat thing that's pulsating. The men's will literally be like the size of a twig. The females have that nice plump one just so they'll be able to produce babies later on. Oh my gosh. Is that the thing's eyeballs? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Dude, literally, I say this every single video, but imagine being the roach. Imagine feeling all that pain. That would just be horrible. Oh my gosh, look at that abdomen. This is a good macro shot. It's a real good shot. The hell? Autofocus be messing me up sometimes, guys. God damn, look at those blues on her beak or mandibles. It's kind of like a beak, but I probably shouldn't say that because all the invertebrate people would be hating because it actually ain't no beak. Damn. God damn, god damn. All right, we're going to let her finish up that thing because you ain't about to take up the whole goddamn video. I got my centipede that I'm trying to feed. We got three different roach sizes. Okay. And with centipedes, even though they could probably take down a pretty decently sized prey item, it's not the best to give them one that's really big. Especially one that just molted. Because it is going to be weak from all the stress it endured from the molting process. So we'll decide which roach we should feed it. Let's first open this bad boy up. Okay. Let's remove the cork bark. And yeah, so it is looking a little bit skinny. Should be hungry. Its fangs or modified legs do seem to be nice and hardened up. Can't really see from those stains. But yeah, you guys can see they look nice and hard. They would be more white if it was not ready. Doubt that the centipede's gonna eat right now. Yeah. I think the centipede still needs to harden up. Centipede looks really scared. I need to get this roach out. Yeah. So guys, I am going to wait longer because I think since it's a bigger centipede, I'm going to have to give it more time. If my sister doesn't stop doing weirdo stuff, I'm going to kill myself. Yeah, I'm probably going to have to give it more time before I start feeding it again. I'm going to give it another week. Maybe sooner. I don't know. Because this thing is really, really stressed out from the fact of that roach crawling on it. You can see its antennas bugging out. Yeah, I'm definitely going to give it more time. Well, that was a fail. I'm sorry, guys.
I had to just grab my isopod meal real quick. And it's kind of like this jelly sort of thing. You're able to cook it into gel. Like, how can I explain this? Like, kind of like water gel, but a little bit more different. And yeah, you could either boil it, jello, pretty much like jello, bruh. Why the hell was I saying water gel? Yeah, you could turn it into jello, but I just give them the powdered version because that works just as well. So yeah, this is what I feed my isopods. You know what I'm saying? Low key, when I was at the reptile shop that I bought it from, probably didn't even need to buy this, bruh. My oak leaves and my decaying wood matter is probably enough, but I just love spending money, bro. Especially when it's not mine. Sadly though, this was my money, so kind of a waste. But for real, let's get into the isopod.
Okay, this is my isopod container, and so far, something doesn't look the best. One of my isopods seem to have passed away. Either from old age, or I'm not taking good care of them. I think I'm taking good care of them. There seems not to be any other ones that have passed, thankfully. So, this is my little container. Actually, do need to give them a little spray. So we got the mister, you know what I'm saying? The flammer, full flammer. Oh, yeah. Boy. You just gotta, you know what I'm saying? Calcium low-key screwed over my freaking mister, bruh. I'm getting a new one for my birthday, so I can only use it on this setting, which is kind of annoying because it's more of a blaster or a water gun than a mister, but oh well, you know what I'm saying?
We'll just spray the side so it breaks up the impact of the water. Because science out here. Out here being a smart freaking child. Let's see what the hell is going on. Oh. Hello there, beautiful ladies. Look at all them isopods. Just chilling, chilling. Could also be called wood louse. Have a bunch of different names. I don't know the exact species. It's kind of hard to differentiate what the hell I actually have in this container, but yeah, all I know is this is where I cultivate. Oh, there's a little baby right there. My isopods to put into my tanks. Oh, there's a few right here. Now, I actually do want to know. Oh, is that a little baby? It seems to be a little baby. The white thing. But yeah, you see how there's one that's more like shiny? I'm pretty sure these are two completely different species. If I'm not mistaken. I think that one's actually a wood lice or a wood louse. And I used to keep a spider that would eat wood louse. It's this big orange spider. It's called the wood louse spider. I forgot. But yeah, let me know if I should catch one of those from outside again. Because they're invasive where I live. And they were kind of cool. Nice big orange fangs. I'm pretty sure you guys seen them before. Especially if you live in California. Or where they're actually from. I think they're from the UK. If I'm not mistaken, I'm not 100% sure. Yeah, got another one. And yeah, we could go through this container pretty much all day, but let's not do that. Let's add the food. Where is it at, though? Don't you just love life? I literally didn't record this part because I thought I would spill. But my dumb ass really still spilled, bro. Oh my gosh. Now I gotta vacuum. Jesus, bro. Well, anyways, you might as well just dump it in here from here, bro. So yeah, this is what I do. I just sprinkle little bits on the top. Just like this, little sprinkle sprinkle. And yeah, the isopods eat it up nice and fast. You don't wanna put way too much, even though it looks like I'm putting way too much, but nah, this is actually a good amount because, well, the reason why you don't wanna put way too much is because you might get mold. So this is, I would say, a good amount. You know what I'm saying? Maybe should have done a little bit less, who knows? Gotta get this junk all off of me. Let's see if I could do the shoe so I don't have to vacuum. Oh, now I do have to vacuum. Dude, I don't know how Exotic Layer does it, bro, with one hand. I keep on losing focus on what the hell I'm doing. Okay, take off my shoe and let me just like that.
Oh my gosh, what the hell is this video, bro? I'm really teaching y'all how to put isopod mix on your shoe and then pour it into the container.
And now we have some on my sock. Oh, well. Okay, guys, seeing how that was such a freaking fail, we're just going to go back to the praying mantis. She has been halfway done with this roach already. Just chewing up those insides. Jesus Christ. And yeah, so word of advice, if you have a bigger centipede, definitely give it more time for its exoskeleton to harden, because that probably does make sense. The bigger the animal, the longer its exoskeleton would take to harden. That's just common sense, but I'm commonly stupid, so that's cool. Anyways, this praying mantis is just devouring that goddamn roach. Beautiful colors as always. She even has speckles like in her eyeball, which is just amazing. Super plump, bruh. I'm telling you, that girl must be pregnant. You cannot tell me by looking at this thing that is not pregnancy. And my sister really doing this right now. In the kitchen. Let's just do a time lapse real quick of the mantis eating. So yeah, I think that's the end of today's video, guys. I try to make it a 10 minute long video and hopefully I can edit it down to 10 minutes, but knowing my stupid ad, it'll be like 15, 16 minutes, but I can't. Oh, there we go. We got that snap. So yeah.
I used to have my, I need to take off these old labels, bro. I used to have my scorpion in this.
Getting late, dude. All right, and yeah, guys, that's the end of today's video. This was a fail. That was a success. This one was in between, so yeah, I'll see you on the next one. Late!
And I made this out the green. I couldn't find no more late. It's bad. Bitch. Oh, shit. Clowns, they all hate me. Nobody never gave me nothing on my baby. Where was you when I was hitting gates and masons? Scuff marks, and I just bought these yesterday. Bag chasing and the cool drag racing. These niggas dorks, all you niggas will get torched. We know who winning, you ain't gotta check the score. Off this mud, I'm abusing more than grow. Off of 20, I would say I'm more than Paul. These niggas J-Cats, I'm flu-flamming off PayPals. TMOP sticks on the couch on my K-file. But don't nobody know you in the dead playing foul. And all these bitches want you when they hear you getting out. But I ain't fucking with them, the fuck I look like a clown, goddamn. Too busy flu-flamming masters. I told a baby, what's up with all them niggas you bare-bagging? You curving niggas on the gram, but you's a backseat bandit. I told the bitch I was too busy flu-flamming mansions. You curving niggas on the gram, but you's a backseat bandit.
Say so the Mac, I'm flu-flamming her trap. Backseat with the trick, busting bare back. 20 Hondas with the bitch, better bring back. You wiping the hoe, you better get that ring back. The twat got elastic, backseat bandit. She ate two Xanax, fucking without a plastic. She drastically out of pocket, she get her ass kicked. Sucking dick with dry lips, get her a chapstick. Say so the Mac, king of fire in the fag, bitch. Broke ass niggas, Macazan got a bag, bitch. Pull up at the Slauson just to polish my teeth. I had to break the little bitch before she polished
too
my meat.
Too busy flu-flamming matches. I told her, baby, what's up with all them niggas you bare-bagging? You curving niggas on the gram, but you's a backseat bandit. I told the bitch I was too busy flu-flamming matches. You curving niggas on the gram, but you's a backseat bandit. Damn, baby. I try to figure out what's going on. Like, bitch, like, you wanna, like, curb and all that. Like, bitch, all that followers and all that, bitch. You get 100,000, 3,000, 100,000, million. Like, you the bareback champion, bitch. Like, bitch, you gotta chill out. Like, yeah, you wasn't that cool, bro. Crazy. I'm just talking about, like, damn, daddy. She's a backseat bandit. I'm saying though, hey, free everybody. Hey, y'all know what's up.
Damn it, I dropped something.
Did you know what
it was just a beautiful subscriber. Hello and goodbye.